This module's concept, we will discuss few programs related to the placement perspective. So after finishing those Pythons, so those programs, we will conclude this entire core Python. So in the next class onwards, we will start advanced Python. So which is related to career specific Python. So out of those, so initially we will discuss few modules which are related to networking as well as GUI, graphical user interface. After finishing that stuff, we will move to the concept called NumPy, Pandas, and Matplotlib, which are related to our machine learning. So in the today's class, we are going to discuss concept called module. So here, before this thing, module is nothing but, so here, into a very function. So function, what is the purpose of function? So same logic multiple times. In order to avoid multiple usage of same logic, we are using functions. That is about functions definition. So after that thing, we have concept called modules. After this, we have concept called module. So here, module is nothing but collection of functions. So here it is the technical definition for this thing. After this module definition, we have package. Next thing is a package. Package is nothing but collection of modules. In other words, so we can say module is nothing but our folder. It's a folder which contain modules. So here function is nothing but collection of statements. After that, module is nothing but collection of functions. One module may contain only one function or more than one function. After this thing, we have package. So package is nothing but collection of modules. So here we can say package is, so someone doing nonsense, so please rough the board, don't make this kind of nonsenses while explaining something. Yeah, who did it? Okay, done. So no problem. So here package is nothing but it is a collection of modules, or it's a folder which contains a module. So before this thing, modules are majorly categorized into two types. So first one is the user defined modules, second one is the predefined module. User defined modules are the modules which are designed by the user. So based on your requirement, if you design any module, that is called as user defined module. So whatever the program, so based on your requirement, if you design one module, that is called as user defined module. So in the previous class itself shown you that thing. So in the today's class I will show you that thing. So here I am opening the basic program. So in the document folder, I kept one file in this form. So here, the program. So here in this program, I defined four functions. First is for addition, second subtraction, next multiplication, next division. After defining all these functions, I am calling these functions and I am executing this portion. Whenever we execute this portion, it is asking us to enter A and B values. So here, it is a basic program which contains four function. That is nothing but it is a module. What is the module? What is this module name? I kept this module name as Calci. So here I want to create new script here, and here I'm saying import Calci. So here I want to import this program in one more program. After this thing, I am saving this program. So for that purpose, here I'm typing control S. After this, I'm keeping name as T3. I'm keeping some random name to this thing. And I'm executing this portion. Whenever you execute this portion, directly it will retrieve you, or it will take you into this original program. So here it is our original program. Whenever you call this function, it will retrieve you into this thing. So whenever entering into this thing, it will ask us to enter two values. So here I'm entering operand one value as well as operand two value. So here it is a import is a keyword which is used to import any module. This is nothing but one user defined module. Based on your requirement, you can define or you can write any program by using multiple functions or single function. So everything or every function or collection of function, whatever the program you run in Python, that is a module. This is nothing but one user defined module. So after that thing, next one is a predefined modules. Next one is predefined modules. Yeah, just yeah, next one is the predefined module. So these are the module which are come up with the setup. Whenever you download the Python platform, you will get this predefined modules. So predefined modules are the modules which are come up with the setup itself. Wait a minute. Yeah, these are the module which are come up with the setup. So to import any module, we have keyword called as import. So here import is a keyword which is used to import any module. For suppose if you want to import math module, so here I'm importing math module. So for that purpose I am saying import math. Whenever you import this module, so here I want to know the functions which are present in this math module. So here I'm entering directory of math. Whenever you ask a directory of math, it will return all the functions which are defined in this math module. So here these all are the functions which are defined in the math module. These all are the functions which are defined in the math module. After that thing, if you want to know about any function present in this thing, so here for that purpose we need to take help. So here I'm saying help of, in the math module I want to know about tan function. So here I want to know about adjacent tan function. So for that purpose here I'm saying a tan. So whenever you ask the help regarding this thing, it will return help about this thing. Return the arc tangent. Whenever you give the value, it will give the value in the form of arc tangent. So here I want to give one value. So here I'm giving math dot a tan of, so here I'm giving 60 here. So here by default, whatever the value you are giving inside this function, it will take in the form of degrees. Whereas inside this thing, we need to give value in the form of radians. Again, in the math, we have radians function to convert the degrees into radians. So for that purpose, here I'm saying math dot a tan of. So in this thing, here I'm saying math dot, I want to convert this thing into radians. So here I'm saying radians of 60. Whenever you say radians of 60, initially that 60 degrees will be converted in the form of radians, and next you are converting that radian value in the form of arc tangent. So here it is about math module. Not only this function, in the math module we have lot of functions: truncation function, tan hyperbolic function, square root function, sine hyperbolic function, sine function, radian function, power function, pi function. So like that we have lot of functions. So here this is the one advantage of Python. So here it is a modular programming language. So if you want to do something, you need not to write program for each and everything. Directly you can take help of math module. So if you want to perform any mathematical calculation, you can take math module. Like that we have statistics module also. Not only it is only one module. So here another way. So first, initially we will see the different ways to import this module. So different ways are, first we need to use import keyword to import any module. After that thing, we need to specify the module name. Whenever you want to import the module, we can specify this thing. So this is the first way. After this thing, so whenever you specify the any module with the module name, whenever you want to use the any function corresponding to this module, you need to use module name everywhere. So to avoid that problem, we need to import this module with some alias name. So here I am importing this module by using alias name. Here I'm saying import module name as M. So here I am importing this module with this alias name. So to make it clear this thing, I want to import statistics module by using this alias name. So here I'm saying import statistics as s. I want to import this module with alias name. After this thing, whenever you want to call the any function corresponding to the statistics module, simply we can call this by using this alias name, that is by using this character. So if you observe this thing here, whatever the function you need to call from this math module, everywhere you need to use this math. Whereas here we need not to use the statistics every time. So here I want to take mean value. So for that purpose, here I'm taking mean value of 1, 2, 3. So here I'm specifying 1, 2, 3, and I'm running this thing. Whenever you run this thing, it will give the mean of this thing. Like that, in the statistics module, we have mean function, mode function, as well as variance functions also. So here I want to know the directory of this S. So here I want to know the directory of S. So whenever you ask the directory of S, so it will return all the functions which are defined in this math module. So here in the math module, we have all these functions: variance, standard deviation, power variance, power standard deviation, numbers, mode, low median, high median. Like that, we have a lot of attributes present in this statistics module. So like that, we have random module also. It is another way. So here it is one more way to import the module. Like that, if you want to import multiple modules at a time, so if you want to import multiple modules at a time, so same thing. So first we need to specify the import keyword to import any module. So after that thing, we need to specify module 1, comma module 2, comma module 3, so on dash. So how many modules you want to import? You can import any number of modules by using simple single import keyword. So here it is importing multiple modules at a time. Whereas if you want to import multiple modules with aliasing name every time, so for that purpose, we need to say import module 1 as M1. Next, comma, here I'm saying module 2 as M2. Like that, you can import multiple modules by using aliasing names also. So after this thing, we have one more way to import the specific function from any module. So here, if you want to import the specific function from any module, so here it is a syntax: from module name, import specific member. So member of that specific thing. So here I want to do same thing. I want to perform statistics only. So here I am using same thing. So it becomes very large thing, I think. So here itself I want to import same thing. Here I will do that thing. So here I want to, from statistics, from statistics module, import, I want to import mean function from this statistic module. So whenever you want to use this mean function from this module, so next time you need not to call this mean attribute even. So here directly here I'm saying mean of, so here I want to take mean of 1, 2, 3. Call any number of functions at a time. So here I want to call mean function as well as mode function also. So here I'm calling two attributes at a time. After this thing, I want to know the mode of these values. So here I want to know the mode of same values. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm executing this portion. So here it is giving an error. Like, which kind of error it is giving? No unique mode, found 4 equally common values. So here, to found the mode, what we need to have? So here, we have frequency of any value into multiple times. So here I'm saying 1. So whenever, so here I'm specifying comma 1. So if you observe this thing here, mode is 1. So what do you mean by mode? Mode is nothing but it returns a value which is repeated most of the time. Whereas if you observe previously, we have each probable values. So each value occurred only one time. That's why it gave a warning. So in this thing, it is giving this thing as an output. So here it is about the mode function. So it is a way to import the specific function from any module. Like this, if you want to import these functions also by using alias name. So here we can say import mean as m. And here I want to import this mode as this thing also I want to import with the m2. And next time if you want to perform the mean, we can perform simply by using this m character. So whenever you perform this thing, it will return name m is not defined. So before that thing, we need to run this portion. So after running that portion, we need to run this portion. So whenever you run this portion, directly we can access this mean by using this alias character. After that thing, we need to perform mode. To perform mode, simply we can call m2. Whenever you say m2 of something, mode of this thing. So here, these are the different ways to import any module, or it is a way to import the specific function from any module. So like this, if you want to access any module from the function, so here it is a way. So next, from module name, import star. Whenever you say this thing, by using this syntax, you can access any attribute from that module directly. So here I'm saying import math, from math import star. So I'm running this portion. Whenever you say this thing, we can access the any function from this math module. So in this thing, I am calling sine function. I want to get a sine 45 value. So directly we can call sine value. That means, so what it means here we are opening the book. So by opening this book, we can access any function from this module. So here it is a way to access any member from the module. These are the different ways to import the module. So in the real-time scenario, we are using these modules in the lot of practical cases. So if you observe Ludo game, on that Ludo game also, we are generating random number in the range of 1 to 6 every time. So for that purpose, we are taking help of this random module. So in the random module, it is a very important module for random number generation. So by using this random module, I will explain you how to generate a random number. So here initially, I am importing the random module. I want to import this random module by using some alias name. So here I'm saying import random as R. After importing this module, in this thing, random dot, I want to choose choice function. To generate a random number in the range of 1 to 6, I am using this choice function. So here, I want to generate a random number in the range of 1 to 6. So here, I'm taking numbers in the range of 1 to 6. And I'm running this portion. Whenever you run this portion, initially it returns output as a 6. Again, I'm running this portion. It will generate 6. Again, I'm running this portion. So here, how many times you run this program, it generates a random number for each and every time. So for each and every time, it will generate a new random number. So like this random choice function, like that in this thing, we have lot of functions to generate a random number. So like this, we have rand range function also. So here like this, we have rand int function also. So here I'm saying r dot rand int. So here, initially I'm specifying wrong thing in this. So here I'm specifying 3. So whenever you enter 3 here, it will return syntax error. So here it will return syntax error. Initially, I don't know about this rand int function. To know about this function, we need to ask help. So here to this, I am applying help. So whenever you ask help regarding this thing, it will give the syntax corresponding to this thing. I am running this portion. Whenever you run this portion, it is giving rand int of a comma b. So in this rand int function, we need to specify two attributes. These are the start ending and starting range of these values. So here, to generate a random number in the specific range, we need to use this rand int function. So in here, I am following the same syntax. In this rand int function, here I am giving the numbers in the range of 1 to 6. In the range of 1 to 6, I want to generate a random number. Whenever you execute this thing, it will generate one random number. So again, I'm running this portion. It will generate again one random number. So again, I'm running this portion. Again, it will generate different random number. So in a lot of games, so to generate the random number, we are using this random module. So by using this thing, I want to develop a simple game. So that is random guessing game. So for that purpose, initially what we need to do, we need to import this random module. So here, initially I'm importing this random module. So how to import this module? Import random as I want to import this thing with alias name. After taking this thing, I want to generate a random number in the range of 1 to 10. I want to generate a random number in the range of 1 to 10. So for that purpose, here I'm saying a dot r dot rand int function. So here in this thing, I am using rand int function. After this thing, I want to generate number in the range of 1 to 10. So after generating this random number, I want to guess this number in the five chances. So for that purpose, I'm taking one for loop. So here I'm saying for I in range of, one comma 10. I want to generate a random number in the range of 1 to 10. So I want to guess this number in the 5 chances. So for that purpose, here I'm saying 0 comma 5. Or else, 0 comma 5 only. So here, I want to get 5 options to guess that randomly generated number. So if, here after entering into this thing, we need to guess that number. That means we need to enter one user-defined number. For that purpose, here I'm taking one user-defined input. I want to take that input in the form of integer. So here, I'm entering enter a guessed number. I want to guess a random number. So for that purpose, here I'm entering enter a guessed number. So if this guessed number is equals to generated number, if a equals to b, which is nothing but if the guessed number is equals to the randomly generated number. If this condition is satisfied, it needs to return like print, you won the game. So it needs to return like you won the game. And after executing this statement, we need to break our program. Whenever this condition is satisfied, we need to break our program. So if randomly generated number or randomly guessed number is not correct, so if enter number is not correct, we need to execute this portion. So here we need to get leftover options to us. So here LF, I have 4 more options. So for that purpose, here I'm saying 4 minus I. So here I'm saying LF 4 minus I greater than 0. Whenever this condition is satisfied, till that time I want to execute this portion. Here I want to print leftover options. So whatever the options left over, I want to print that thing. So here you have, you have leftover options. So leftover options means 4 minus I. And here I'm saying comma options, try again. You have this many options, try again. I want to get that thing. So here I want to guess that randomly generated number. I want to get 5 options. So for that purpose, I'm taking this thing. So if this condition is fails, else, I want to return output like you lost the game. Here I want to get output like you lost the game. After that, I want to get the randomly generated number. So here I want to get that randomly generated number that is stored in A, right? So for that purpose, here I'm saying A is randomly generated number. So here it is a program. And I'm running this program. So whenever you execute this program, initially by default it will generate one random number in the range of 1 to 10. And initially it is asking us to enter a guessed number. So initially I'm entering 10. So whenever you enter 10, so here it is not equals to B. It is not equals to A. That means randomly generated is number is not equals to 10. And the next it is checking this condition, 4 minus I. So for the first iteration, I value will be 0. That means it is entering into this thing and it is executing this portion. You have 4 options. Try again. Again, I'm guessing the random number. It will again proceed to this thing. Here again, I'm guessing that random number. And I entered 9. So 9 also not randomly generated number. And it will proceed to this thing. And it is reminding us to leftover options. So we have 3 more options. Try again. And I'm entering number as some 7. So here, here it is. A, here A becomes equals to B. That means here randomly generated number equals to 7. So here in this case, randomly generated number equals to 7. On that case, it will return output like you won the game. So here it will return you won the game. Like that, you can develop any game by using random model. So here it is a basic example. In this example, I am taking few more things. In the first case itself, I won the game. So here, randomly generated number is 9. And at the first case itself, randomly generated number equals to the given user defined number. So on that cases, it is giving output like you won the game. This is about modules. So regarding these modules, I will forward you the documents corresponding to these modules. So if you are interested to learn about these modules, so you can go through that document. So if you are not interested, you can leave that thing. But if you want to build your career by using Python, so if you want to become an expert in Python, better to go with this thing. So it will be helpful to you a lot. So in the next classes, we will discuss a lot of modules. So those are coming into advanced Python. So before that thing, in the today's class, we will discuss few advanced program corresponding to data structures. So coming to this data structure, first program will be reversing a words from the given string. Reversing words from given string. So here, so I will take model example. So in this model example will be, so if you give input like this, so here if you give input like hello, hi, good evening. So if you give input like this, I want to reverse all the words present in this thing. So if you give input like this, output will be in the form of evening, good, hi, hello. We need to get output like this. We need to perform this program. To perform this program, we have different approaches. So I will explain you different approaches for this program, and I will explain you a few more programs corresponding to this concept. So here, for this, what we need to do initially, we need to take one user-defined string. So how to take one user-defined string? We can take this thing by using input function, as well as we can take by using evaluate function. So initially, I want to take this thing by using input function. Initially, I'm taking one user-defined string by using input function. So here, we need to enter a string. Here, it needs to ask us to enter A. So after this thing, what we need to do? Yeah, we need to split this string. So here, simply, we can't split the words easily. We are unable to reverse the words directly from the strings. To perform this action, here I'm taking help of list concept. So here I'm storing this result in the form of list. So for that purpose, here I'm splitting this thing. Whenever you split this thing, so I'm observing the output, what is present in this list. So if you observe, it is asking us to enter a string. Hi, good morning. So here I'm saying, hi, good evening. So whenever you enter this thing, it is output. So here we are taking all these words in the form of list. For that purpose, here we are applying split function present in this string concept. After this thing, what we need to do, we can do this thing in different ways. Initially, we will do this thing by using basic for loop. So here I want to iterate through this list by using Pythonic way. So here I want to iterate through this thing. So here I'm saying for. So here I'm saying for in, I want to iterate in reverse manner. So here I want to iterate from the back side. So here to reverse any data structure, we have this is only the standard syntax. So to reverse any data structures, it is only the standard syntax. So after this thing, to make it clear, I want to print the I value each and every instance. So here I'm entering hi, hello. So I'm taking simple example. So here, whenever you execute this portion, it will return output like hello, hi. That means here words are reversed. So here words are reversed. So after reversing this word, I want to store this thing in one more list. For that purpose, here I'm defining one more list, and that is an empty list. Here I'm defining one empty list, and I want to append these words into this empty list. So here I'm saying L2 dot append of i. So here after executing this entire program, we need to print the output of L2. So here we need to enter user defined input, that is hi, hello, good evening. So here I'm entering this string. So if you observe this input, so here we gave input like hi, hello, good evening. So here we got output like evening, good, hello, hi. That means in this list, we got all the words in reversed order. So after getting this output, we need to join all these outputs in string format again. We need to join all this word. How to join this word? So to join all these words, here I'm taking output attribute. So to join all the attributes present in this list, we need to use join function. And I want to join each and every attribute with the space distance. I want to join each and every attribute with the space distance. So here I want to join each and every attribute present in this L2. After this thing, I want to observe what is the output. So here I'm executing this portion again. So here I'm saying, hi, hello, good evening. So whenever you enter this portion, here it is the output. So here, evening, good, hello, hi. It is a way to reverse words present in a string. So for this, we have a lot of ways. So we will see one more way. We can do this thing by using basic while loop also, as well as we can do same thing by using for loop also, by using range function. Initially, I want to do this thing by using range function. So for that purpose, I am copy pasting same thing till here. Till here, corresponding to everything is same. So here I'm copy pasting that thing, and I want to do this thing by using basic range function. So here I'm saying for I in. So here we need to use range function. In this range function, what we need to do, initially we need to specify the starting index. So starting index is nothing but length of L minus 1. We need to take minus 1 to this thing. Why? Because so length returns the number of attributes present in this thing. So here we will get one more extra attribute. Whereas index starts with 0, that's why here I am specifying ending index as minus 1 of the length. After that thing, we need to specify the starting index, that is 0. So if you specify 0, 0 will be excluded. To include 0, here I am specifying the minus 1. And we need to print all the words from the backward direction. For that purpose, we need to specify step size as a minus 1. So after this thing, we need to append each and every attribute into our original list. So here l2.append of, we need to append i2 this thing. So after this thing, again we need to perform same thing. After appending this thing, we need to perform this thing only. So whenever you execute this portion, again it is asking to enter as a string. Hello, good evening. Yeah, why it gives sequence items? Yeah, why it is giving error? Sequence item 0, expected string insert int found. So here, okay done. So if you do like this, what it returns? So here, yeah, good. So whenever you perform this thing, what it returns? So here, it will return the character present at each and every index. So here, we are obtaining indexes. Whereas if you want to get the value corresponding to that thing, here we need to say L of I. If you want to access by using this thing, here we need to specify L of I. So here after this thing, I am performing this operation. So here I am entering string now. Hi, hello, good evening. So here it is output. So in the both the cases, we got same output. So try to do this thing by using while loop. Take this thing as a simple assignment. So to save this time, I'm not explaining same thing by using while loop. So do that thing on your own. So after this thing, yeah, we will take one more example. So in this example, word should be present at same location, whereas we need to reverse the characters present at each and every location. But suppose if you give input like this thing. So here, if you give input like hello, hi, hello, good evening. So yeah, not like that. So if you give input like hi, hello, if you give input like this, input is like this. So output should be in the form of word should be present at same location, whereas word should be present at same location. So here I'm saying, hi, hello. and I want to get output. So output will be in the form of, I want to get output in the form of, so I want to reverse the character which has presented the same location, IAH, and I want to reverse the character presented same location. So whenever you give this kind of input, I want to get output like this. To perform this action, we need to write a program. How to write that thing? So initially, first step is same thing only. Initially, we need to take one user-defined string. After taking one user-defined string, so we can take string in different ways. We can take directly by using input function, or else we can take by using evaluate function. So here I'm taking by using input function only. So here initially we need to enter a string. After entering that string, we need to split that string and we need to store that output in the one more list. So here we are splitting this thing. After splitting this thing, what we need to do? We need to iterate through this list. So here we need to iterate through this list for I in L. So after iterating through this list, we need to reverse each and every character present in this, each and every word. So for that purpose here, so to store that result, here I'm taking one more list, that is L2. So here I'm defining empty list L2. So in this thing, what I'm doing? So here I want to append each and everything. So in which way I want to append? Word should be presented at the same location, whereas I want to reverse the character corresponding to each and every word. That means I want to reverse each and every word. So here I'm saying this thing. And after performing this thing, if you observe L2, you will get a difference. So here it is asking us to enter a value. Hi, hello, good evening. So here I'm saying this thing. So whenever you enter this thing, so here all words are reversed. So here we get all the words in reversed order. Whereas we want to get this output in the form of list again. We need to get this output in the form of list. So for that purpose, here what we need to do? So here I am using join function. I want to join each and every word with the space distance. And here I want to join all the words present in this list too. I want to join all the words present in this list too. And I want to observe that output. So for that purpose, here I'm saying output. So here it is asking us to enter a string. Hello. Good evening. So here I'm saying this thing as a string and I'm running this portion. So here it is a way to reverse each and every word present at same location. This is about one more program. You can do this thing also by using different ways. So after this thing, so we have one more program. So if you have input like this, so here if you have input like A4, B2, C5. If you have input like this, you need to get output like, so here if you have input like this, you need to get output like, you need to get A4 times, and you need to get B2 times, and you need to get C5 times. You need to perform this action. So to perform this action, what we need to do here also, initially we need to take one user defined input. How to take this user defined input? So here by default user defined data type is string only. So for that purpose, initially we need to take string data. So here I'm taking input by using input function only. So here we need to enter s. We need to enter s value. After entering s value, what we need to do? So here we need to store output into one more string. For that purpose, here I'm defining one empty string initially. So after defining this empty string, we need to iterate through this defined string. We need to iterate through this defined string. For that purpose, here I'm iterating through this defined string. After iterating through this thing, so for each and every iteration, we need to check whether the given character is alpha, beta or not. For each and every instance, we need to check whether the given character is alpha, beta or not. So for that purpose, here I'm saying if, so here I'm storing the result in I, right? I dot is alpha. If the given character is alphabet, if this condition is satisfied, if the given character is alphabet, what we need to do? So we need to store that character into output plus equals to I. We need to store that character into this output, and we need to store same character into previous. So here in the previous also, we are storing this X only. So in the previous also, I want to store this X. So after storing this thing, else, if this condition is fails, if it is not an alphabet, If it is not an alphabet, we need to proceed to this else condition. So here, whenever this else condition is satisfied, we need to perform this thing. So here, we need to make output equals to output plus. So here, previous output plus previous into, I want to convert the given number. So here, initially we have input in the form of string. We need to convert that string in the form of integer to multiply that thing. To perform repetition operator, we need to convert that character in the form of integer. After that thing, here I am reducing that character for one time. So I will explain you tracing for this program. Don't worry about this thing. So after performing this thing, after executing this entire program, we need to print the output. So here, after this thing, finally we need to print the output, which is stored in OP. So here I'm storing that thing. And I'm running this portion. After running this portion, so here I'm giving same text input, A4, B2, C5, D3. I'm giving this input. Whenever you give this input, so here it is giving error. Which kind of error it gave? Here, name X is not defined. So here somewhere I use it X. Where I use it X. So here, yeah, here I use it X. So here I need to store I. So here I need to store I. So here it is asking me to enter the input. So here I'm entering same input. So here I'm saying A4, B2, C5. So whenever you give this input, so here we got output like A repeated 4 times and B repeated 2 times and C repeated 5 times. So coming to tracing, so whenever you did any program, whenever you want to write any program, so initially you need to aware of tracing of that program. To understand that program, you need to aware of tracing of this program. So here I'm tracing this program. So initially we took input like, so here we took input like A4, B2, C5. So I will explain you tracing for only one instance. So I will explain you till A4 only to save the time. So here initially what we are doing, initially we took this input as a string. So here in the string we have A4, B2, C5. And here in the output we don't have anything. After this thing, we are iterating through this entire string. So for the first instance, I value will be first character, that is A. So whenever entering into this condition, it will check this condition. If this given character is alphabet or not. So coming to this thing, this A is an alphabet only. Whenever this condition is satisfied, we need to store the given character into output. Now output becomes A. After that thing, we need to store same output in the previous thing also. So here we are storing or we are adding that thing into output. So here we are adding this character to output and we are storing that character into previous. Till here we have this thing. So after this thing, it will come out of this thing and I value will be incremented. For the next instance, I value becomes 4. So here I value becomes 4 and after entering into this for loop, it will check this condition if the given character is alphabet or not. So coming to this thing, it is not an alphabet. So here condition fails. Whenever this condition is fails, it will directly proceed to this else block. So after proceeding to this else block, so we need to store output. So previously in the output, we have previous character, that is A. After this thing, we need to multiply that thing with the previous character. In the previous character, we have A only. And we need to multiply that thing with int of I. So here, this 4 is in the form of string. We need to convert the string character into integer number. To perform repetition operation, we need to convert that character in the form of integer. So here we converted that number in the form of integer. Now it will become 4. So here we have A one time. So previously we have A one time. To avoid that problem, here I'm performing -1. So on that number, here I'm performing -1 to avoid one more iteration of this A, one more occurrence of this A. So here, this will become 4 - 1, which is nothing but 3. So A into 3, which is nothing but A repeated 3 times. And initially, we have A one time. So here, A will come 4 times. So like that, so on dash. So for the next iteration, I will become B. And that will be added up to this output. In the output, we have this thing. So for the next case, B is an alphabet. This condition is satisfied. Whenever this condition is satisfied, we need to add that character to output. So in the previously in the output, we have 4 A's. So 4 A's, here we are adding B. So after that thing, So this iteration also over. After that thing, I will become 2. I becomes 2. After becoming 2, here we need to check this condition again. After that thing, we need to check this condition again. This condition fails. Whenever this condition fails, we need to enter here. So here, after that thing, here output is nothing but output equals to output plus. So in the output, we have 4SB plus we need to multiply. In the previous character, what we have here, if we observe output, in the output, we have this thing. In the previous, we will have B. So after this thing, we need to multiply something with previous, right? So here in the previous, we have B. So here we need to say B into, we need to convert this two in, string 2 into integer 2, 2 minus 1, which is nothing but 1. B into 1, which is nothing but 2 times B. Sorry, B into 1, which is nothing but 1 time B. And we need to concatenate this B with this thing. So now that will become 4 times AB. And here we have one more B. So it will become this thing. For the next iteration, it will become that thing. So I think you might understood this thing. So here I'm proceeding to one more question. So for the next question, so if you give input size, so here it is the tracing of the program. So after tracing of this program, so I'm taking one more example. So that is, so if you give input like this, so if you give input like A2, B4, C2. If you give input like this, then you need to get output like, so here you need to get output like into one more resistor. So here I'm saying output equals to previous equals to, for this purpose here I'm defining one empty string. After this thing, what we need to do initially, we need to iterate through this entire defined string. So for that purpose, here I'm saying for x in s, I want to iterate through this entire string. So after iterating through this string, so what we need to do, we need to check whether the given character is alpha bit or not. Again, I'm checking same condition. Here I'm checking if x dot is alpha, if the given character is alpha bit or not. I'm checking this condition. If this condition is satisfied, I want to perform same thing what we did previously. So in the output, I want to store that character. Output plus equals to x. I want to store that character into output. And I want to store x into previous. I want to store that x into previous. If this condition is fails, if this if condition is fails, I want to perform one more operation like previous operation only. So here I want to perform output equals to. So here I want to perform output plus equals to. So here I want to convert that thing in the character finally. Char of. So here I'm performing ordf. So here I want to apply this thing on previous values. So here previous plus int of x. So I will if I explain you the tracing of this thing, you will understood this portion clearly. So there is no difficulty here. So if you practice this kind of programs more and more, you will get clear idea of this thing. So after performing this thing, finally we need to observe the output. So here we are storing that entire output in the OP. So here I am observing the output and I will execute this program initially. After that I will explain you the tracing. So we'll give the same input whatever I took in the test case. So here I took input as A2, B4 as well as C2. So this is only the example which I took. So and I'm running this portion. So whenever you execute this portion, you got same output. So here there is no any difficulty. It is a very easy program. And if you trace this program, you can understand this thing very clearly. So initially what we did, here we defined string in the form of A2, B4, C2. So here it is a defined string. So after this thing, we are iterating through this thing. So initially in the output, we have a nothing. And previous also, we don't have any. So after this thing, we are iterating through this thing. So for the first iteration X, we have A, first character A. So whenever the given character is alphabet, what we need to do, we need to store that character into output. So in the output, we have A. After that thing, in the previous also, we have same character, that is A only. So after this thing, what we had, so here, yeah, we have this thing. So after this thing, again, we need to proceed to this for loop and X value will be incremented. Now X will become 2. So after making x equals to 2, here we need to check this condition. If the given character is alpha, beta or not. So this condition is failed. Whenever this condition is failed, we need to proceed to this else block. So here we need to make output plus equals to what we need to do. So here we need to convert char of. So here char of. So ORD of previous. ORD of previous is nothing but ORD of A. ORD of A is nothing but it will return ASCII value of A. For that, we need to add int of the present character. So int of x is nothing but present character. So in this example, int of x is nothing but int of 2. We need to convert this integer in the form of 2. So here, before this thing, you need to aware of this char function. What is the purpose of this char function to convert? Any character, any ASCII number to character conversion, to convert any character into its equivalent ASCII number. Sorry, ASCII to char conversion, we need to use char function. To convert any ASCII number into its equivalent character, we need to apply this char function. So before that thing, we need to aware of this ORD function. So by what is the purpose of this ORD function? So initially, before the thing, we need to convert character to its equivalent ASCII. Character to its equivalent ASCII number, we need to use this ORD function. So here, if you observe this example, so initially what we are doing, we are converting this character A into its equivalent ASCII number. So coming to this A, its equivalent ASCII number will be 65. So for that 65, we are adding 2. So here, we are adding 2 means it will become 7. So after taking this number in the form of ASCII, after this thing, we need to know the equivalent character corresponding to this 67. The equivalent character corresponding to the 67 will be, equivalent character corresponding to this thing will be, so 65 plus 2, which is nothing but A plus B plus C. That is nothing but C. So here, like that, you can easily trace this program. So here, it is about this basic program. So like this, I will forward you lot of programs corresponding to this thing. So after finishing the session, I will forward you the core Python book. So if you are interested, if you want to prepare any interviews regarding Python, go through that entire book. So you will get a lot of stuff on that book. So if you got any doubts anywhere, feel free to ask me at any time. So I will help you. I will ready to help you at any time. So this is about today's class. Thank you. With this, I am concluding for this session. So yeah, good. Thank you. With this, I am concluding.
నువ్వు పెద్ద ఇన్ఫార్మల్ దాన్ని నన్ను ఇన్ఫార్మల్ అంట చులు 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 ఇది పిల్ల ఇట్లా గుంజ
ఎంత రాలిందో
బా మోనీ చుట్టూ అది వచ్చిన
Thank you.
ఇదేంటి వచ్చింది ఇదేంటి అందే అంటే Yeah.